Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What another beautiful and awesome day today to always be in the presence of the Lord. Another day right now to give him all the thanks right now, to give him all the praise right now, and to give him all the glory. Today is the day that the Lord has made, and every last one of us should always be glad and always rejoice in it. We serve an awesome God. We serve an amazing God. We serve a powerful God. We serve a God who is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. We serve a God who still sits on the throne, who still performs miracles and wonders each and every day in the mighty name of Jesus. He is still in the healing business. He is still in the blessing business. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. And he is so worthy. Yes, he is. He is so worthy to be praised. I don't know about you, my brothers and sisters, but I cannot go out without a day without thanking Jesus, without praising him, without worshiping him, without even glorifying his holy name, because he is that awesome. He is that amazing. He is all of that to me, and he should be all of that to you. Think about everything that the Lord has done for you. Think about the times when you got yourself in trouble and you know that you did wrong, but God still came through and helped you out. If it wasn't for Jesus, you wouldn't be here right now today. He woke you up today. He breathed life inside of you today. He blessed you with your health and your strength today. He gave you another chance and another opportunity today to make something out of yourself today. See, he already did his part. See, Jesus does not owe us anything. Every last one of us owe him. We are in debt with him. So when I say thank him and praise him, but I don't want you to thank and praise him because you want something or you're in need of anything. But I want you to start thanking him. I want you to start praising him. I want you to start glorifying him for who he is and what he has done, because you should be in love with him. You should be committed to him. You should be dedicated to him. You should have a hunger for him, and you should have a thirst for him. And he should be your first love, and you should always put him first place. That's why praise is an everyday thing. It's not an on and off switch thing. It's not a seasonal thing. It is an everyday thing, because the God we serve, the God we praise, he watches over every last one of us. And he has in the palm of his hands. And he is working everything out to his perfect will. And if you have not welcomed the Lord into your home, to your life, or even your prayer closet room, and if you don't have a personal relationship with Jesus, I want to encourage you right now today. Please do so. His arms are open wide. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, we just come before you right now today in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me all thanks today. Give me all praise today. Give me all glory. We just thank you, Heavenly Father God, for everything that you've done and everything that you're doing. We thank you, Father God, how you're moving in our life right now. We thank you, Father God, how you order our steps. We thank you, Father God, for your guidance and your direction. We thank you, Father God, how you move through us right now, how you're uplifting us right now. We thank you, Father God, because it is you that is in control. It is you, Father God, that's in charge. We thank you, Father God, for your grace and your mercy. We thank you, Father God, for your love that you continue to give us. We thank you, Father God, for how patient you are with us, God. We thank you, Father God, for this word that we better receive today. This powerful message right now today, Father God, that's going to keep us full today, keep us satisfied today. And there's no other place, Heavenly Father God, that we ready to be at right now today, Jesus, but right here in your house, right here in your sanctuary, Father God, giving you all things, giving you all praise, giving you all glory. Let your will be done today, Father God. Let your words go out and she never turn by void today, Father God. Oh, Father God, allow your love to move through this place. Allow your presence to move through this place. Allow your angels to join with us in praise and worship, Father God, in this place right now today, Father God. Oh, Heavenly Father God, your word said, with two or more gather in your name, hallelujah, that you are in the midst right now. And Father God, I believe and I declare right now today that you're in the midst of this prayer right now. Oh, Father God, that you're holding us tight right now today, Father God. Oh, Father God, speak a word to us right now today, God. Lift our spirits up right now today, Father God. Oh, Heavenly Father God, you know exactly what we're going through, what we're facing right now. And Father God, it's not too hard for you. It's not too difficult for you, Father God. And Father God, even though it seems like that we're losing, God, Father God, we know by faith, God, that we are winning, Father God. And we are trusting you, Father God, even in the midst of our storm, even in the midst of our pain, even in the midst of our suffering, even in the midst of our hurting, Jesus, we are still trusting you, Father God. And we give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory, Father God. Oh, Heavenly Father God, this is your time. This is your moment. That I know for a fact that you're about to show up. That I know for a fact that you're about to show out. I believe and I declare, I decree right now today in the mighty name of Jesus that someone's going to be healed today. Someone's going to be delivered today. Someone is ready to give their life over to you right now today, Jesus. And the angels are rejoicing in heaven right now. And you will, and you shall get all the thanks, all the praise, and all the glory. Heavenly Father God, this is your house. The house that you built on solid ground. The house that you built on solid foundation. The house that cannot be moved, shaken, or bothered. Heavenly Father, Abba, Father, you are welcome right now. You're invited right now today to enter to the house of the Lord. Right here in your sanctuary. Right here on your YouTube channel. Right here on your platform. Right here in my brother's home. Right here in my brother's life. Right here in my sister's home. Right here in my sister's life. Heavenly Father God, I'm asking you right now today in your holy, precious, mighty name for you to do a new thing in my brother and sister's life right now. I'm asking you right now today, Father God, for you to move supernaturally in their finances right now, in their health right now, in their dreams right now, in their business right now, in their homes right now, in their relationships right now, in their marriages right now. I'm asking you right now today, Father God, to put them at the right place at the right time right now. I'm asking you right now today, Father God, for rain for my brothers and sisters, Father God. I'm praying, I'm asking you right now today, Father God, for you to open up some doors for my brothers and sisters right now. I'm asking you right now today, Father God, to send some help to my brothers and sisters right now. And you know the help that they need right now today, Father God. And Father God, we know that you will listen to this prayer. Father God, we know that this prayer has been heard and this prayer has been answered. And Father God, we give you the thanks for it right now. We give you the praise for it right now. And we give you the glory. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you are welcome right now. You're invited right now today to enter to the house of the Lord. Right here in your sanctuary. Right here on your YouTube channel, right here on your platform. Right here in my sister's homes, right here in my sister's life. Right here in my brother's homes, right here in my brother's life. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to intercede and intervene right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to comfort us right now today because you're a comforter. I'm asking you right now today to control our thoughts, control our mind, so we hear your soft, still voice right now. Holy Spirit, I'm asking you to move through this place like you never moved before so we catch the Holy Ghost fire. As we repent of our sins today, Father God, please forgive us for our sin today, known and unknown right now. Wash us through your blood right now. Clean us as white as snow. Heavenly Father God, I want to say thank you right now today for forgiving us for our sin. Thank you, Father God, for not remembering our sins anymore. Thank you, Father God, for the clean slate. Words cannot explain how thankful, how grateful, how honored, how blessed I am to always pray, praise, and have fellowship with all my brothers, all my sisters, and one body in Christ. Heavenly Father God, I'm here today to let you know that I'm available for praise. I'm available for service. I'm available for the kingdom. But most of all, Jesus, that I'm available for you. Heavenly Father God, before I get started, it's something that's always in my mind about you. It's something that stays in my spirit about you. It's something that stays on the fruit of my tongue and fruit of my lips about you. And I just got to tell you how I really feel about you, Jesus. I just can't thank you enough, 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 Jesus. I just can't thank you enough. That's why I praise you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I glorify you the way I do, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I magnify and I shout out your holy name the way I do, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I pour my heart into you every day, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. That's why I'm in love with you the way I am, Jesus, because I can't thank you enough. I just 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 can't thank you enough. Glory, hallelujah. I just can't thank you enough, Jesus. And if you're ready for God's word, let the church say amen. The word for the day is, be aware of fake love. In this season, my sisters, in this season, my brothers, there's going to come a time when people are going to show you fake love, but pretending like it's real love. In this season, my brothers and sisters, there's going to be some people that's going to come back into your life who you once knew. And they're going to pretend like they really care about you. They're going to pretend that they really love you. They're going to pretend like they really want to be with you. But you got to be self-aware that it's not going to work, that it's not real, that it is fake love. It might be a friendship. It might be an old fling that you had. It is fake. because they see something on you. They see that anointing on you. They see the blessing on you. They see the breakthrough on you. They see the light that's shining on you. And when they see all that on you, they already know that God is doing something in your life. They want to know what the secret is that God has shared with you. They want to know what the secret is, what God has spoken to you about. They want to know what's on you because they want it for themselves. And they're going to pretend like they really care about you. They're going to pretend like they really love you. But at the end of the day, my brothers, at the end of the day, my sisters, it's never going to work. It's not going to work. They're going to sell you out for somebody. They're going to pretend they want to build with you, and you're going to sit there and build with them. But they're going to take what y'all build together and take and go share it with somebody else. You better believe it. This season, my sisters, this season, my brothers, this is the time that you really spend time with the Lord and ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, if this person intentions, are they real or are they fake? Is it real love or is it fake love? Because if you don't ask those questions, they're coming with fake love. Their intentions for you is not real. It's not pure. And you will see sooner than later. But I'm here today to advise somebody. Today, right now, you need to open your eyes and see whoever they is. Because somebody just came back to your life pretending that they really want to be with you. Pretending that they want to make amends. Pretending they want to start back over with you. But it's never going to work. It won't work. And the reason why it won't work because it's fake. The reason why it won't work because it's not real. The reason why it won't work because it's not authentic. The reason why it won't work because they only want what's best for them. That's what happened in this story. See, one person went in with their whole heart, with their whole eyes, their whole heart into this person. And that was something y'all going to do. You going in pure. You going in right. You going in with your whole heart. You going with the right attention, but theirs not. You looking at them like you really want to be with them, but they looking at you like they really don't want to be with you, but you can't see it because it's so much fake love that's right there in the midst of it, and you is not aware of it, my brothers and sisters. But you got to be aware of what's real and what's fake. Because if you don't open up, you're going to be in a lot of devastation. And God right now today is trying to prevent you from not going down that wrong road, that wrong path. Are you understanding what I'm saying right now? Because it's going to happen. It won't work. I don't care how long you've been knowing this person. People do change. Some people change for the better. Some people change for the worse. And they put their mask on pretending like they changed for the better. But as time go on, you're going to see that mask going to fall off their face. You're going to say, wow, you're the same person the whole time. But don't get so deep involved with these people. Right now, you need to spend time with the Lord. Right now, you need to ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, am I wasting my time with this person? And this person's intentions, are they really true or is it fake? And the Holy Spirit going to let you know if it's real or not. Do not get bamboozled entertaining fake love. Do not get bamboozled with somebody who's pretending to use you or manipulate you or pretend like they really care about you or pretend like they really love you. Because they want to know what the secret is about you. They see the secret on you. They see the glow. They see the light. They see the anointing on you. They see it on you. That's why they're sneaking in they're back into your life. Just to see what they can get out of you. But don't you be the fool. And don't you be the show that's involved in the circus. Remove yourself from it. Amen? Amen. So let's turn our Bible to Judges. Chapter 16, and we're going to read verses 4 through all the way 21. That's Judges, chapter 16, and we're going to read verses 4 all the way through to 21. And if you have your Bibles open, let the church say amen. And glory, hallelujah. Sometime later, he fell in love with a woman in the valley or Sirach, whose name was Delilah, the ruler of the Philistines, went to her and said, "See if you can lure him in into showing you the secret of his great strength." Do you see that? Do you see that? He fell in love, but she didn't fall in love. His intentions was real and pure, hers wasn't. See, she got paid to lure somebody in. And right now, somebody's paying their friend to lure you in, my brothers and sisters. Somebody's praying that, is paying this person to pretend like they want to be in a relationship with you, my brothers and sisters. But don't you be the fool. See, you already fallen in love with the idea. You already fallen in love with the concept. You already fallen in love that it's going to work. But it's never going to work because it's fake love. It won't work. Because one of y'all going in the right way, the other one is not. Are you following what I'm saying? So they go to verse 6. So Delilah said to Samson, "Tell me the secret on your great strength, and how can you be tied up and subdued?" This is how she went in. See, they see the secret on you. They see it on you. That's why they coming in with the wrong intentions. So you going in, eyes open wide, heart pumping like Kool-Aid. You going in the right way, but he not. Samson answered her, "If anyone ties me with 7 fresh thrones that have not been dried, I become as weak as any other man." Then the rulers of the Philistines brought her 7 fresh thrones that had not been dried, and she tied him with them. And with the men hidden in the room, she called to them, "Samson, the Philistines are upon you." But he snapped the thongs as easily as a piece of string snaps when he comes close to a flame, so the secret of the strength was not discovered. So Delilah said to Samson, "You have made a fool of me. You lied to me. Come now, tell me, how can you be tied?" Do you see how she's still manipulating? And that's what these people are going to do to you. They're going to manipulate you because they want to know what's about you. They want to know how you're shining so much. They want to know why you're glowing so much. They want to know how people are looking up to you. They want to know what God is up to in your life. It's a secret that they know about you, and they know that God is using you. They know God has showed you something in a dream or a vision. They know God has spoke to you, and they want to know what God has actually showed you and told you about. They want to know. And they're not going to stop and give up until you give it to them. But you got to be smart enough. You got to be wise enough not to open your mouth, because what they're trying to manipulate you out of something. They're not in it to be in it with you. They're not in it to win it. They're not in it to be no friendship with you. They're not in it to be in a relationship with you. They're in it just to see what they can get up out of you, my brothers and sisters. I don't care how long you've been knowing this person. It will never work. You trying to reconcile with somebody. If God ain't bring that friendship back together, it ain't real. If God ain't bring that man or that woman back to you, it's not real. If all of a sudden they locate you on social media through Facebook and Instagram and TikTok and all that, it's not real, my brothers and sisters. Because God ain't finna bring nobody from Instagram, TikTok, Reebok, or Meemark, or nowhere to bring back to your life. He's going to put you at the right place at the right time for y'all two can be back together if it's in his will. But don't you be the fool and sit there and get all excited and thinking that something good's going to happen out of this situation, because nothing good's going to come out of it. It's all going to go down to waste. And it's not going to be real. And it's not going to work. I don't care how long, I don't care how you try to make it work, it's not working. And right now today, some of y'all right now today, you are stressing yourself out trying to make something work. And the reason why it's not working, because it's not real. The reason why you and that friend, y'all keep hitting heads, because it's not real. The reason why you and that somebody and their relationship not getting along, because it's not real. Why you think y'all can't hear so much? Why you think y'all ain't getting along so much? Why you think y'all can't see eye to eye so much? Because it's not real. If it was real, yeah, you're gonna have little hiccups here and there, but you're gonna have that many problems. You're gonna have that many headbutts. It's not real. Pay attention to the signs. God's showing it to you. He revealing it to you. You got to be wise enough and know what's real and what's fake. Come on, somebody. Go to verse 12. So Delilah took new rope and tied with them. Then when the men hid in the room, she called to him, Samson, the Philistines are upon you. But he snapped the ropes off his arms as they were threads. Delilah said to Samson, until now you have made a fool of me. Lie to me. Tell me how you can be tied. Now this is the second time. Samson should have known the first time it was not right. The first time he told her a secret, but it wasn't the right secret. She had somebody hiding. Did it again the second time. The first time should have been an alarm. So you know what? This right is not real. This right has got to be fake. It's got to be something about it. But Samson was so in love with Delilah, he overlooked it. So he gave her a second chance. And she did it to him again. So she did it to him a third time. Please tell me your secret. Samson kept telling her what he wanted. Samson kept telling her what she really wanted to hear. And what she wanted to hear, she believed him, thinking that's what it was. So God was still giving Samson all these chances. God was still giving Samson all these warnings. Hey, bro, get up out of there, because this woman do not like you like you like her. This woman is not in love with you like you in love with her. This woman do not want to be in this relationship like you want to be with her. It's done. It's fake. It's not real. And Samson was so blinded by love, as some of you are right now today. Some of us right now today, we get blinded by love thinking that it's real. We get blinded by friendships thinking that it's real. And the whole time it is fake. Come on, my brothers and sisters. God has given you warnings. God has been opening your eyes so many times, and you still overlooking. You still giving this person chance after chance after chance, just like Samson was doing Delilah. You can't see that person have a Delilah spirit inside of them. You can't see it, my brother. You can't see it, my sisters. God is telling somebody right now today that the person that you continue to give chance to after chance to, and you see what they're doing, they have a Delilah spirit inside of them. And what you're trying to make some work, God is telling you right now today, is never going to work, because it is fake. It's not real. I don't know who I'm talking to today. I don't know who this word is for today. Stop pursuing people who's showing you they really want to be with you. Stop pursuing people who keep showing you that they really not in love with you the way that you in love with them. You treat them the way that they treat you. Give them the same kind of energy. Because what you're trying to make work is never going to work, because it's not real. It's not going to work. But you are forcing it. Do you see how Samson was trying to force Delilah into something? But Delilah, she kept it real. She came in herself. She's like, I don't see this man how this man see me. And that what their friend is telling you right now today. I don't see you how you see me. That what that so-called man or girl or whoever they are, they don't see you the way that you see them. But you're pursuing them so hard. You're trying to convince them so bad. But they showing you who they really are. I don't care how long that you've been knowing them. It ain't going to work. And at the end, Samson had to realize who Delilah really was. And he realized it didn't work after God had took his strength away from him. But Samson cried out to the Lord and said, God, if you give me my strength one more time. And he gave him his strength, but they died. But look what he had to come to. You don't have to come through all that, my brothers and sisters. If God has given you a warning, and if God has given you a red flag about somebody, you need to pay attention, because it's something about that warning and it's something about that red flag that God is trying to show you. Open up your eyes. You should know the difference between somebody who really want to be with you and somebody who really don't want to be with you. There's a difference when somebody want to fight for you who don't want to fight for you. There's a difference when somebody showing you real love and someone showing you fake love. Know the difference. And if you know God is talking to you, and this word is for you. Say, thank you, Jesus. I need my eyes to be open. Now, I know you've been showing me, but this word is really showing me really who they really are. And this word moved through you today. If it touched you today, go and hit Jesus' like button. Go and hit the subscribe button too as well. Can you please pray with me? Lord Jesus, I ask of you to come into our life to guide us, direct us, use us. I believe right now today in the mighty name of Jesus, by us praying this simple little prayer, that God is already working everything out in our life right now today. And if you ever want to get in contact with me, leave me a comment. My YouTube channel is withers.lt. Always keep Jesus first place. Always seek him. Always honor him. Always keep your eyes focused on Jesus, because he is the author and the perfecter of your faith. Continue to trust him even though you don't see things happening. Continue to hold on to his unchangeable hands and please do not let it go. Continue to pick up your crosses and follow Jesus. Choose faith over fear. Always continue to pray for your fellow brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if you know them. It doesn't matter if you've ever seen their face. Prayer helps and prayer changes things. I'm always going to continue to keep y'all in prayer, my brothers and sisters. The only thing that I ask y'all guys to do for me is continue to keep me in prayer and keep me lifted up too. I'm 7 Minutes LT. I love y'all. Stay blessed. In Jesus' glory, holy mighty name. Amen.